the road on the way to Loughborough, and my wonderful friend Nicole is driving me. Thank you so much. And we've got Janice in the back there. Say hi.
Hi.
So guys, if you can't see, so I'm gonna start off with this. This has been my week. So my eyes are a lot better, it's not hurting anymore. Still a little bit red, you can still see it, that's it, the difference. But I'm gonna put some pictures of what it looked like this week. Suffering with that this week. I don't really know exactly what happened, but yeah, in terms of sleep and being tired, it's been hard, because especially Tuesday night I couldn't sleep. Wednesday it was still hurting, so all of that. It's literally, I don't know why, but I've been like so drained and so tired this week as well. So it's been a bit of a difficult week, but we have made it. And I didn't wear contact lenses like all week to try and get my eye to a place so that I could wear them today, because I tried to run with glasses at training, and it's just, this is why I don't wear glasses at training, because the way they're bouncing, it's just so distracting, and I'm trying to not let them fall off so I can't run properly. So it's a no, but I've managed to wear them today. So my eye feels a lot better, so hopefully it's okay today. But it's Loughborough International today. I've just got the 100 metres, I'm not doing the relay. I did actually initially get selected, but for this year I thought it's best that I just don't do any relays and just focus on 100 meters. And so yeah, so last week was Middlesex, guys, and I'm gonna insert my vlog that I started to make last week here, and you'll see what happened. So watch this now. Ridiculous. I basically thought my race was at 1:15, which is the final time. I walked in and they're like women's 100 meters. I'm literally like, what? So I tried, guys, I really tried. I tried to see if they can still do the final. I tried to see if I could run in another race, just to run, but I missed it. I obviously just assumed, because Middlesex is always a straight final, I clearly assumed that there was no heat and straight final. But then again, like they said, when there's a straight final, it's usually run at the heat time anyway. So that's my bad. And yeah, I'm actually disappointed, obviously, because at exactly the time that the 100 was running, it was actually a really nice day. Like I was saying just earlier, I wanted to use it as an opportunity. And there we go, once again, Chima has missed opportunity. I don't know, I just don't understand. But basically, it is what it is. I will just have to wait till next week, which is Loughborough. I desired to run one this time before, but you know, it is what it is. So we shall just have to get over it. It's my fault, no one else's fault, is it? It's mine. So there we go. I've actually never missed a race before, so this is the first time for everything, guys. I think I was just really lazy with this. It's really bad. I didn't check. I did check again, but I checked exactly the same way. I checked assuming. This is why assumption is bad. Here's the result of that. I just assumed. And I'm sure when I counted, there wasn't. I don't know, anyway. I even looked on the list again last night. I don't know, guys. I don't understand. Don't understand. I really don't understand. But yeah, I'm at Lee Valley. Haven't been at Lee Valley for like 6 months, and I don't really want to talk to no one, so I'm just sitting far away on the side, basically. So annoying. So annoying. Anyway, guess I'll see you guys next week. Bye. So yeah, basically I missed my race, and yeah, but basically the Lord did something that day, so there was a reason, and so we give praise to God for what he's done.
contain what it is he has done. I can't explain what it is through my testimony.
Hi guys, so I just came outside to record my vlog. Just ran my race, I ran 11:95. Basically, I hate saying stuff went wrong, it's so annoying. But I what happened was I lost my footing. So.
Go cast.
In lane 5, we have Shannon Hilton who will take our first 100 meter.
It would I only would have run about 11:85, but I lost my footing at the end of the race. The person that I was ahead of ended up ahead of me and run 11:08 something, so I would have run about 11:85, basically the same as last year, which is again okay. All I know is that I just need to compete. What I'm happy with today is how I was able to stay composed, warm up, get through, like not feel any pain apart from my shoulder that started hurting me, I don't know why, but legs wise, like everything else is good. I just need to compete, that's it really. So I'm just happy that I did a basically chicken out, because I have this little mental thing that when I'm about to run, I literally like, oh, I can't wait for it to be over, which is really bad. I want to enjoy racing. Like, I actually want to enjoy racing. So I can't really say I enjoy racing yet. I don't really enjoy racing. I want the result, but I don't want to do it. But basically, yeah, so today was 11:95. At least it was 11 seconds, and at least it's a step forward from last time I ran. That's all I can say, and just keep going. I just want to, obviously my main goal is to stay healthy, so at the moment we are fulfilling that, so praise the Lord. And yeah, all I can say is let's just keep progressing each time. If you keep progressing, you can't really complain. Obviously in my heart of hearts, because I'll just be honest with you guys, it's really hard when you haven't run where you haven't run at the standards you've been at before. So until I get back to at least 11:05, 11:06, I can't even think about pushing towards the goals I want to push towards. So that's really, I just want to get back to where I was, you know, before I took a break from in my junior and under 23 years. I just want to get back to at least that, so that then I can push on to what I believe and know that I can do. So I just have to continue, because if I give up then I'll never get there. So I just have to continue. And again, I just want to say it's hard when you're by yourself, because you haven't got a team and everything, but just knowing that if the Lord is for you, who can be against you? So I'll just continue. But yeah, thanks for watching this vlog guys. I didn't miss my race today. I made it, I ran the race, I'm healthy, and we took a step in the right direction. I guess it was a tenth off, it's something. So just need to race and see how it keep going. We're only in May, still got season, and by the grace of God I actually have a season to keep progressing, because even in the years that I'm saying I want to get back to, I never ran 11:05, 11:06 straight away ever. So let's just keep pushing forward and see what this season brings. So I'm learning, or I've been humbled, like I've really been humbled all the way down to the ground. I said it on my Instagram, but I haven't said it on my YouTube channel. I've really been humbled all the way down to the ground. So it's just, I don't know what to say guys, there's so many things I want to say, but I can't think to say. But anyway, thanks for watching this vlog guys, and I will see you next time. Bye!
Guys, how was your day at Loughborough?
Janice,
you're not.
Don't record.
You haven't got a spoon in your mouth now.
You are horrible. I had a spoon in my mouth and you just let me on one.
How was that for
it? I'm bare chamming.
Huh?
I said, I'm bare chamming.
Yeah, it's my first time in Loughborough.
I look like I'm a 5 year.
I do what I have then? Denise?
Yeah.
Have you been loving
my face clean? I've never been. It's really lovely actually.
She likes places that have nothing
this
in it.
This is a nice, it's a nice, it's different to sitting in the stands and sat
yourself. Yeah. Thanks for coming, guys.
Thanks for having me.
My God ain't got limits. My God ain't got limits. My God is the reason.